Hi! Hello! Welcome back to Gilisanya Engineering Videos, your daily supply of solutions to engineering problems. If you like what you see, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we upload new videos. In this video, we will solve a recent, passboard exam. Not very recent, passboard exam in structural engineering and construction. Ayan. And this problem was given, I think, 3 times already. No? 3 times. The most recent was 2 years ago. So, medyo hindi pa naman ito masyadong luma. No? So, in one of the exam, ang tinanong niya lang ay yung mga factors of safety, ganon. It's about foundation lang. Another problem, ask only for the foundation pressures. And the third one, papadesign yung stem talaga. So, kinover ko na lahat dito. So, binigay yung dimension natin. No? So, yung A is 0.25. Ito yung retaining wall natin. B is 0.7. C is 0.8. D is 3.5. Okay. E is 6 meters. H is 6.5. So, meaning yung F natin is 0.5. At sinabi dito, the active air pressure coefficient is 1/3. Unit weight of soil is 17.2. Concrete is 24. And then, the required strength is 1.2 dead plus 1.68. So, ginawa ko na lang siyang 2015, where D is the dead load and H is the earth pressure. Consider 1 meter strip of wall left. Okay, and neglect passive earth pressure. I-neglect natin tong part na yan. Ayan. The first 3 or 4 questions are with regard to soil. Mechanics lang. Yung wall, stability lang ng wall. The factor of safety against sliding, known ang mu. And then the factor of safety against overturning, and then the maximum gross foundation pressure and the minimum gross foundation pressure. And then yung 5 and 6 is the design na of the stem. Okay, we will have that 5 and 6 later on. Okay, ito yung ating figure. Dilagay ko yung data. So 3.5 yung D. So minus 1.5 here, that will be 2 meters. So kompitin natin yung mga forces acting on this wall. Divide natin. Unahin natin yung soil. Unahin natin yung vertical forces. For the soil here, the centroid is here. Tawagin natin yung W1. Na? And for the concrete, divide natin to into... For the, unahin natin itong base. So, the centroid is here at nasa gitna exactly. Okay, tawagin natin yung W2. And for the stem, divide natin into triangle and rectangle. Na? So, this is 0.7 minus 0.25, that's 0.45. So, this is, tawagin natin itong W3. Ayan. W3, rectangular part. And this triangular part here, tawagin natin W4. Triangular part, so W4. Okay? So, W1 up to W4. And then, we need the moment arm kasi magmo-moment tayo dito sa toe. Ito yung toe natin. So, we need the moment arm from that. So, the moment arm galing dito, tawagin natin X. So, hindi ko na lang lagyan ng label, no? X1, X3, X4, and then you have X2. Okay, another force is the lateral force, the total active soil pressure. Tawagin natin FA, and it acts at 1/3 of 6.5 from the bottom. No? So, 6.5 over 3. Okay? Now, kukunin natin yung RM at saka OM. Yung RM natin is caused by these 4 forces, which is taking or causing moment towards the upstream side. Yan yung RM. Yung FA naman ay mag-cause ng OM. Ito yung OM natin. Ito yung ating RM. Okay? Sige. Now, para maging accurate yung ating mabilis saka accurate, gamitin natin yung power ng calculator natin. Gamitin natin yung statistics function. Mode 3-2. Na? Mode 3-2 ng ating calculator. Ito yun. Mode 3-2. Dali. Mode 3 and then 2. On natin yung... Make sure na naka-on yung ating frequency. Na? So, kung hindi kasi naka-on yung frequency mo, punta ka dito sa shift and then mode and then scroll down and then stop. Meron dyan on at saka off. Sa kanon kasi, once the off mo na, pag on, pag turn on mo pa na ng calculator mo, naka-off yan. Kaya i-on nyo muna. And then, dito ka sa mode 3 and then 2. Okay? So, yun. Sa X, ang ilalagay natin yung moment arm. Sa wide, just leave it blank. Sa frequency naman, ang ilagay natin yung kanyang forces, W1 to W. Huwag natin isali, hindi kasali dito yung FA, ha? Ibahin natin yung FA. So ito yung table natin. Ha? So unahin natin yung 1. So yung X natin is from here to here. And that will be 3.5 minus natin ang kalahati ng 2 or minus 1. And then the Y, never mind. Na, zero naman yung default value niyan. Yung W naman natin is unit weight of soil times the volume. That is 2 meters by 6 meters by 1 meter. Okay? Yan. Next, yung ating W2. So for the W2, the X is kalahati ng 3.5. Na? And then the weight is equal to the unit weight of concrete times the volume is 3.5 by 0.5 by 1. Okay, next, yung ating W3. Your moment arm is, okay, what is that? 1.5 minus kalahati ng 0.25. 0.8 plus 0.7 minus half of 0.25. I hope you can follow that. And then the volume is equal, the weight is equal to 24 times 0.25 times 6 times 1. And then for the triangular part, the centroid will be 0.8 plus 2/3 of 0.45. 0.8 up to dito. Yeah, 2/3 of 0.45. And then the weight is equal to 24 times 1/2 of 0.45 times 6 times 1. Okay? So, ayun. So, ito yung magiging itsura niya doon sa calculator natin. Na? So, to get your resultant, and that resultant is also your RY. Your RY na dito, no? RY. To get that, that will be the value of N. RY equals N. Ito yung lalabas sa calculator ninyo. How to get that N? Sandali. Dito yan, no? Ups and then 5, S bar and then N. Pag press mo yung equal, lalabas yung 316.8. Okay? And then for the writing moment, the writing moment is the product of W and X. Now, W and X. To get the value of that sa calculator natin, ito yun. Ups and then 4, S sum, and then summation X. Pag press mo ng equal sign, ito yung lalabas. That is now your RM, product of X and W. That is your RM. So, mabilis siya. Other than mabilis, accurate siya. If you know how to compute this one, then mabilis siya. Kasi ito yung nagpapatagal. Mako-compute ka pa, isusulat mo pa, and then i-multiply mo pa, i-add mo pa, masyadong matagal. Na? Again, this is not a shortcut. The shortcut is just a bonus here. Ang principle talaga yung importante. A sort of for those who knows how to solve it. Parang yung marunong, this will really help them. Pero yung kahit marunong ka ng program, hindi ka naman marunong ng principle, wala rin. Na? Okay, may RM na tayo. Next yung OM natin. So we need to compute our FA. Active pressure. That is 1/2 Ka gamma H squared. Ito yung H natin, ha? Total height. And then times 1 meter. Yung kino-consider natin. So your active force is equal to 121.117. So with that, makukuha natin yung OM natin. So yung OM is FA times the moment arm. 6.5 over 3. So you have your OM. Okay? So we can now solve the factors of safeties. Una is against sliding. Against sliding will be mu RY over RX. Mu RY. Mu RY is the frictional resistance. RX, ito kasi yung RY natin. Na? Okay, RY. Yung RX natin is the X component of the reaction that will be equal to FA lang. Wala namang ibang horizontal force. Your RX is equal to FA 1 to 1. So, ang answer dito is 1.622. 1.622. So, ito yon. Letter B, 1.622. Your OM na, I mean, your FSO naman is equal to RM divided by OM. Okay, RM is ito. OM ay 262. The answer is 2.57. 2.57 is ano yan? Ito, letter A. Okay, next, the maximum gross foundation and the minimum gross foundation pressures. Okay, ito. Bakit gross? No? Kasi lahat ng weight kasali na. Lahat ng weight, yung concrete, pati yung ating soil. That is gross. You do not compute here net. Yung net, nasa mga footing lang yan. No? So when you analyze the soil stability, you use the gross. No? When you analyze, when you design the footing, that will now be the net. In this case, gross yung hinahanap. Kasali lahat ng weight. So meron na tayong RM, OM, tsaka RY, and then yung B natin ay 3.5 meters. Yung L natin, remember, this is 1 meter. Na? So first, kunin natin yung bar X. The resultant RY, saan yung location niya coming or galing ng toe? The formula is RM minus OM divided by RY, and that will give us 1.301. So nandito lang banda yun, no? Nandito banda yung ating RY. RY. Alright? Now, next, alamin natin kung may uplift ba to para malaman natin kung we can use the combined stress formula. No? Alright, so kunin natin yung eccentricity. So that is the distance from the centroid of the base to the RY. Ito yung E natin. And that is equal to kalahati ng B, no? From here to here is B over 2 minus bar X. Ito yung bar X natin. Ha? Ito yung bar X natin. Location of RY from the toe. So B over 2 minus bar X. And that gives us 0.449. Now, okay. So, i-check natin the value of that. Kung walang uplift, i-compare natin yan with B over 6. So, notice your B over 6 is 0.583. So, hindi siya lumampas ng B over 6. So, ibig sabihin, wala siyang uplift. Okay? Walang uplift. So, ano ba yung B over 6? No? Kung ito kasi yung base mo, B yung ano niya, ito yung gitna. Da? Ito yung middle thirds natin. So from the middle to the extreme edge of the middle third, yan yung iyong B over 6. So meaning, if your ROI will lie anywhere along this middle third, walang uplift yan. So your ROI is from the middle is only 0.449. Hindi lumampas ng B over 6. So wala siyang uplift. So nandito ba na yung ROI mo? So ibig sabihin, the soil pressure is trapezoidal. So, meaning, pwede natin gamitin itong formula na yan. The combined stress formula. ROI is known already. B is 3.5. L is 1. E is known. Then, kayo na lang mag-check itong values. The maximum is using the plus sign. And the minimum is using the minus sign. So, 20.8. And then, maximum is 160.2. Okay lang? Okay lang. Okay, and the last two questions. Compute the maximum design moment. Okay, so in the last two questions, we'll be designing the stem. Okay, so the load combination is 1.2 dead plus 1.6 live. Compute the design moment mu at the stem. Ito yung stem natin. Oh. So the critical part for moment is that sa ilalim. Ito yung ating base. No? We will consider 1 meter width. So, itong part na yan. Okay, so we will only consider the force acting on this stem. The height is 6 meters. Ito lang. Tawagin natin yung FH kasi earth pressure yan. H. Earth pressure. FH. So, the moment arm of that galing dito is 1/3 of 6. So, 6 over 3. So, your FH is equal to 1/2 Ka gamma H squared times B. Of course, B natin ay 1 meter. Yung B natin ay 1 meter. So, that is equal to 103.2 kilonewtons. So, we need the moment. Okay? So, meron tayong dead at saka earth pressure. The dead load is caused by the weight of the stem. And that does not produce moment in this direction. So, our dead load moment is zero. Wala tayong dead load moment. So what we have here is the earth pressure moment, which is FH times 6 over 3. Meron tayo niyan. So that is equal to 206.4 kilonewton meter. So yun lang, dead load at saka earth pressure. So makukuha na natin yung required strength. Na? Okay, the required strength. Doon. Tinawag yan design moment. Pero actually, required strength yan. So 1.2 MD plus 1.6 MH and that gives us 330.24. Basta bagay, yun naman yung principle dito. Dapat yung stem mo at this part must have a design strength of not less than 330.24. Ganun naman yung principle. Okay, and the last part is the spacing of the bar. So, kailangan na natin nung S. So, we will be solving our AS. So, take note, your B is equal to 1,000 mm. Your effective depth will be 700, it is 0.7, minus, sinabi nito, no, use 85 mm cover to the centroid of the stem reinforcement. So, your D is equal to 700 minus the cover effective to the centroid is 85. So, that's 615 mm. Well, of course, we will assume na this is steel yields. And then, not only that, tension control, as expected always. Then, yung Rn natin is mu divided by phi bd squared, where your phi is 0.9. So, this will give us napakaliit. Actually, napakaliit. Kaya sigurado akong tension control dito. Then, from that, makukuha mo yung rho using this formula. Na? So, substitute in the values. Kayo na lang mag-check. The value is 0.00363. Okay? Check natin yung roaming. Yung roaming for this is 1.4 over FY. Kasi yung FC prime natin maliit. Ano? Actually, dalawa yung roaming natin. But for FC prime na less than 31.36, ito yung magagovern. 1.4 over FY. And as you can see, your rho is less than the rho minimum. Ibig sabihin, since we are designing, gagamitin natin yung minimum rho for this. Nagdi-design tayo. We are not investigating. So, your AS will be based on that. So, makukuha natin yung AS. Rho BD. Ito yung rho natin. B natin 1,000. D natin is 615. So, that is it. Now, 3,130. And the spacing is using 1 meter strip. So, 1,000 mm times the bar area divided by the required steel area. Okay? This will give us 100.3 mm. So that's the maximum yan, ha? Maximum. So dapat yung choice mo hindi lalagpas dyan. So according to that, so we will choose here letter D. Ayos? Ha? So kung may hindi kayo naliwanagan, rewind nyo lang, balikan nyo lang, no? So ayan. So I hope you learn a lot from this tutorial or video lecture. So please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon para you will always be notified every time we upload new videos. Okay, so thank you so much for watching.